Welcome to channel Happy Mapping, channel for mappers. Okay, today I'm going to show you how to doing parametric corrections for the Landsat Lake Quality Areas. So, what is the radiometric corrections? Basically, radiometric correction is done to calibrate the pixel value and correct for the errors in the value. The process improves the interpretability and quality of the remote-sensitive data. So, the aims of the radiometric correction is how to calibrate the pixel value and we can get the true value. As you can see before, this is the imagery before and after we doing radiometric corrections. And basically before and then after, in the middle of the process there will be corrections of the value. After we correct the value, we can get the true value of the imagery. And this is the pre-processing in an image. There are two. First is a radiometric correction. Radiometric corrections related to the value, related to something that will make the imagery is not good. And then the second one is geometric corrections, and here is the Landsat 8 and there are 11 bands, consists of 11 bands, and then you can also see the resolutions and wavelength or micrometers. After we know what is the radiometric corrections, and then we know also how we do it, so we go to the next is QGIST, and here we will doing radiometric corrections. But before we doing the radiometric correction, so we have to activate the plugins, and then you can go to the plugins and manage and install the plugins, and here we you can type semi the keywords semi, and then you click semi automatic classifications plugin, and then you can install it, and then the downloading is running and it's done. The processing is done, and then you can see the difference before and after we activate the semi plugins. You can see this SCP menu toolbars, and also we got this, but I will put here. Okay, and then after we activate the plugins, and then we go to the SCP bar, and then we take this pre-processing. You go to the pre-processing and then choose Landsat, because the imagery or the imagery that we want to doing a radiometric correction is a Landsat. So you take this and then double click. Sorry. And then double click like this, and here is the semi automatic classification plugins, and then in here directory contain Landsat bands, you choose the folder of the Landsat. Okay, here is my folder. I make two folders for the output is after and before. I take this before and then you get this before and then select the folder. And here I have 6 bands, which is band 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. And then select the MTL file. As you know, every imagery has MTL file. Take this and then click open. And then we go to the processing and then you click this apply those atmospheric corrections. If you have band of 10 and 11, you may choose brightness temperature in Celsius, but here we don't want to analyze the band 10 and band 11, so we just ignore this and then we just focus on this. After we double click here and then we go to the run, but before we click the run, you make sure that you have to provide the output folders so you can easy to find later your processing results. So I click this and then I click the imagery image after, and then after the processing I could easily find the location of the output, and then I select the folder like this, and then the processing is running. It will take some time, some minutes, because we doing 6 bands, so it will take much time, so we wait. And then here is our analysis is done. How we know it? The layers automatically contain all of the imagery we enter here, and also this is metadata, Landsat A, the date here, and then this is sun elevations and this is earth sun distance. Okay, because our processing already done and successfully, so this is our band, each band that we already analyze it. And you may also know that this is our imagery before we doing radiometric corrections, and then this is the band, each band that we already doing radiometric correction and then put RT, radiometric corrections. And this is our result. So let me show you the difference before and after we doing some radiometric corrections. I add the layer. Okay, this is our band after we doing a corrections, and this is our band before we doing a correction. You can see the difference, even the value. You can see the value, the difference of the value. This is after we doing a corrections, and then this is before we doing a corrections. Okay, that's all of the processing of radiometric corrections. Don't forget to subscribe this channel, like, comment, and share, and see you for the next video tutorial.